Hello. When web scraping, you may wonder how to check if your proxies are running correctly, as successful web data extraction depends on properly functioning proxies. Therefore, testing is essential for ensuring optimal performance. So let me show you how to test proxies, what parameters should be considered, and what proxy checker tools might assist you. So first, check if your proxy is actually operating. To test connectivity, use terminal commands and ping a host. On Windows, launch command prompt and enter the following command. Let's test Oxylabs residential proxies. With a response, you'll receive some basic proxy metrics, such as response time, indicating a functioning proxy. Next, you can use online IP checkers. Lots of them are accessible by searching for my IP, my location, and similar keywords on search engines. Let's visit whatismyproxy.com. It will immediately reveal your IP address and location as well as the HTTP headers of your browser. Although IP checkers can show your IP address and some additional info, their functionality is quite limited. More advanced tools are needed for a detailed analysis. Some websites use third-party IP location databases such as IP2Location or MaxMind to understand who visits their websites and if they are real users. IP location databases have methods to determine whether the IP belongs to a data center or is residential, meaning it comes from a genuine device such as a phone or PC. The easiest way to check proxy status is to visit IP2Location.com. This IP database is widely considered one of the most accurate and allows you to check the details of your IP address. As you can see, it accurately shows that I'm using a VPN service, indicating it is a data center address. Suppose this database recognizes a residential proxy you are trying to use as a data center. In such a case, the chances are that many of your target websites will see the same information and may block your proxy. To test proxy speed, try FOGLDN Proxy Tester. It enables direct ping times to any website worldwide. Since it shows how long it takes to connect, you can use it to monitor the latency of your proxies. You can test any proxy type, including rotating proxies. Just add a list of proxies you want to test. If you are using a rotating IP, you can add it multiple times. FOGLDN Proxy Tester has its drawbacks. For example, if the test run fails, you won't be able to know the exact reason. It doesn't reveal the location of the proxy, its usage type, and the level of anonymity. And you can't control the number of requests made and their frequency. Hidemy.name is a more advanced proxy checker. It can detect the proxy type, speed, and anonymity level. It provides a list of proxies automatically collected from numerous websites all over the internet, including private databases. Proxies can also be sorted by protocol types such as HTTP, HTTPS, and SOX. Hidemy.name can determine the level of proxy anonymity, whether your actual IP address remains concealed, and if there is a chance of the destination server uncovering that you are behind a proxy. Hidemy.name has four anonymity categories. Another thing that is likely to be a matter of concern is whether your proxies are blocked on specific websites. The only way to see this is to test proxies directly on the targeted websites. Your IP might be marked as suspicious at some point, but you would have to make lots of requests before any blocking. The best way to check proxies is to write your own script, as it gives more control over testing. This, however, takes time and effort. The basic approach is to write a scraper that takes a proxy and uses it to extract data from a simple, preferably static website that returns a bare minimum of information. The first step is to understand whether the proxy responds at all. You need to check the content of the body either by looking for a specific string in the HTML output or by checking the content size if the content is static. You can look at the status code in response headers. An HTTP status code 200 would suggest that the proxy worked and you got the content, but checking the actual output is always more reliable. Every request with a proxy should have a reasonable timeout setup. It could be 10 seconds for data center proxy and up to 30 seconds for a residential proxy. If no content returns in this amount of time, you can consider the proxy to be unusable. It also makes sense to log how long it took to complete each request. Some requests may not time out, but they can still be too slow for real-life use cases. All this data should then be written down or printed on the screen for analysis. As evident, the most effective way to test proxies is by using your own script. Other ways are also useful for quick checks or when you lack technical skills. If you have questions about using proxies for web data collection, comment below, email support@oxylabs.io or write to us via the live chat on our homepage. Also, consider joining our Discord community. Thanks for watching.